How good a performer, and I find you to be more objective about this, or at least more willing to be objective than most, so I put this question to you. How good a performer do you think you are on your best night? I'm not talking about people who like the songs and now they come to see you and that whole cachet has been built up. How good a performer?
It depends on the night. Sometimes I'm very, as you say, ironic and objective to the whole thing, and I'm outside of it looking at it. Other times I'm totally involved in it, and I'm not sure who the best performer is, the person who's absolutely involved in what he's doing, or the person who's watching himself do it. And I oscillate between the two. I really don't know the answer. I know how good a songwriter I am. I know that. Performing is something that is a side effect of songwriting, something that I learned to do almost as a side effect. I never really intended to be famous as a performer. I started off as a musician. That was my ambition, to make a living as a musician. Be a performer was something I never really thought about. It just happened.
Can a thoughtful person allow himself to revel, at least for the moment, in the craziness and the adulation and the excess that attaches itself to popular music? When you're up there on stage and the stadium is full, is there always a part of you with an ironic detachment? Or do you let yourself go and say, hey, this is the hand I've been dealt, and I'm gonna enjoy it, at least for tonight?
I always enjoy myself. I love being on stage. I love it. But I'm also objective to it. I don't take the whole thing that seriously. I mean, I don't think that the audience isn't going to be doing the same thing for someone else 2 weeks down the line. You know, I don't think I'm the only one here. But I'm just satisfying that position for the night, you know. But I do love being on stage, and I like playing to large audiences.
How much do you want to act in the future? You've done some films, you've done some stage work, Three Penny Opera here.
I'm not burning with desire to be a movie star. I've acted in, I think, about 10 or 12 films, and I've sort of learned how to act in public, which has been interesting and very challenging. The most demanding and the most interesting work I've done in this field was on Broadway, where you know, you walk out on stage and there's no music, there's nothing. You just have to create the atmosphere with the words.
You were Mac the Knife in Three Penny Opera.
I was Mac the Knife, and this audience was very close. And it was terrifying, and yet I had the best time of my life. And you know, the old cliche is there are no people like show people, and that the cast we had were amazing, wonderful.
A soldier marries the gun he carries from the gate to Mandalay.
What did you learn from that? The critics roughed you up a little bit. They thought you were wooden
bit,
and...
But, I mean, you know, they were expected to. They were just doing their job. I learned how to act. Because in film, you know, you act for like 30 seconds. Mm-hmm. And then you have a cup of coffee and then discuss what you just did. On stage, you really have to sustain what you're doing for much longer periods of time. And I just learned the craft. I learned much more.
Ready to give it a go again?
Then? I'd love to do it again.
How do you see yourself in film? I mean, would you like to play character roles? Or given your presence, I would imagine people would try to find some vehicle in which you could star.
I'm not that ambitious. You know, I mean, if somebody offers me a film which I think is interesting and I will learn something from, then I'll do it. But I'm not sort of just going to do anything just to say I've done a film. I'm not searching.
At this stage of your life, how extensive a tour do you undertake to support Ten Summoner's Tale?
Well, normally I tour for about 15 months every time I go out. It starts out at about a year, and then I say, well, okay, let's just do another month, and another month. It extends the period where I have to, before I have to start writing another record. So I'll postpone it. It's not a very nice feeling facing a blank page. This time I'm committed to a 6-month tour, but it'll probably extend itself.
What kind of venues?
We're starting in small theaters. I believe very strongly that when you begin a tour, you have to let the music dictate what's happening. If you're in a big stadium, the sheer size of it will dictate to the music, so that you have to make some sort of grand musical gesture. I don't want to do that. The music is intimate, therefore start intimate and let it grow organically. So by the end of the tour, we'll be playing large dates.
You have small children. Touring has to be tough, right?
For them.
Yeah. For you as well?
For me as well. I mean, I'm used to touring. I've done it for 15, 17 years now. I like touring. I enjoy it. But I miss the family. I spent most of the last 15 years in hotel rooms. So, yeah, I do miss the family. The kids don't see me for extended periods, but I try and bring them out to somewhere where they can stay, where they'll be comfortable, where they'll have a good time. But I wouldn't drag them around a series of one-nighters, you know, yeah. The Midwest. I wouldn't do that.
What do you hope your kids get from what you do?
Well, I think it's apparent to them that I enjoy my work. And I think if that's a source of inspiration to them in finding work of their own when they get older, then I feel I've done a good job. I like to have them around me when I'm working in studio. I made the last record in the house, in the kitchen. And it's very clear to them what I do for a living. I think a lot of kids are confused by what Dad does. You know, Dad goes to the office. What's that?
Yeah.
What does he do? They see what I do. I shout. I shout for a living. The world's gone crazy, and it makes no sense. There's only one voice that comes to your defense. The jury's out, and your eyes search the room. One friendly face is all you need to see. If there's one guy, just one guy, lay down his life for you and I. I hate to say it, but it's probably